Sweeping changes for Njegoš Popović after resting some key stars in his side's big midweek win over the Sky Blues. Nikki Flannery, Michelle Heyman, Emma Ilioski and Sophia Christopherson all come back into the starting 11. That does mean Tegan Bertolicio, Devin Jackson and Ruby Nathan, as well as Alex McKenzie, all make way. And what a moment for Ish Nori, captain, leader, legend, wearing the armband, lining up in game 100. And what a journey it's been. Debuting as a fresh-faced 16-year-old back in 2013 for the Brisbane Roar, going away from the club, only to return now after toiling away in the NPL. And now becoming the beating heart of this Raw midfield. Game 100, and what a time to raise the bat in front of friends and family. Michelle Heyman, well, she made history on Wednesday afternoon, setting the single season goal contributions record with 22 goals and assists across the season, which was previously held by none other than Sam Kerr. And she's got the opportunity to break yet another one of her records today. She sits just one goal behind Sam Kerr's 2018-19 season record of 17 goals in a season. And there is Alex Smith in his first season at the helm, came in midway through the campaign, relatively early on though. And whilst the season has perhaps not quite gone to plan, he'll certainly be happy with how his side have finished up in red hot form. The officials today, Kate Jakovic and Avril Beacham, as well as a sibling pairing, Paula Malau-Aduli, as well as Paige Malau-Aduli. See them there on the right. What a moment for those two. Njegoš Popović will be pleased as punch with how his side have finished the campaign. And he'll be very glad that they were able to deny Sydney FC the premiership on Wednesday afternoon. And boy, does that set up a tantalising final match day of the Liberty A-League tomorrow afternoon, as Sydney FC host Melbourne Victory in a big blue finale that'll decide the premiership perhaps. Chloe Lincoln, a massive part of that Wednesday fixture against Sydney FC, who is absolutely incredible, denying everything Sydney FC through the Canberra United way. Cannon Clough, you can see there, just in the foreground as well. What a moment it is for her to face her old side. They gave her the chance here in the Liberty A-League, and what an afternoon here at Perry Park. What more could you ask for? The sun's shining, the sides are ready, and what a clash we have coming our way. This Brisbane Roar side, resurgent in recent times and truly looking towards next year. Spoke to Alex Smith prior to kickoff and more just proud with the growth the girls have been on, and as well getting Sian Fryer, who does start today, into that Matilda's squad, her first call up. An incredible moment for her, a player that's battled injuries over recent years in her second stint with the Brisbane Roar now. And boy, has she taken it with both hands. Incredible to see Sian Fryer, Kaya Stevenson stepping up as well this campaign. A player with such promise, such skill, such control. And Alex Smith, well, he's done a great job at the helm of the Brisbane Roar, turning the ship around, has got them playing some really exciting football. Nikki Flannery with a good opportunity herself today, 7 assists across the campaign. And she does manage to get an assist today, she may go clear in the race. Michelle Heyman just needs one goal to equal Sam Kerr's 2018-19 goals in a season record of 17 goals. If she gets two, she'll go clear once more as we are underway in the final round of the Liberty A-League season. Brisbane Roar hosting Canberra United. We are underway. Neville Johnson here in commentary for 10 Play and Paramount Plus. What an honour it is to round out the season with an old school vibe of a clash. Two powerhouses of the competition in its early era. Here's Ilioski. Clough up against her former side. She'll be wanting revenge, no doubt. Here's Scarpelli down the line. Molly Palmer can't keep it under control. Cannon Clough able to sweep up. Now at her third Liberty A-League club, the American. After previously, of course, being with the Brisbane Roar. And since then, the Newcastle Jets. Here's Clough. An American central defensive pairing for Canberra United. Cannon Clough and Sarah Clark. Lovely switch of play. Here's Grove. Air swinging at the ball that time. Here's Sian Fryer, the new Matilda. And her first squad, a big opportunity for her. Here's Jenna McCormick, a big day for her. Of course, the final round of the Liberty A-League season, but we have to give her a big congratulations as well. She got engaged earlier today. So a massive congratulations to both her and fellow Brisbane Roar player Hannah Holgerson on their engagement. Hannah Holgerson out with injury at the moment, the Dane. There she is, the Matilda. A massive day for her, a massive congratulations is in order. Here's McQueen. Norrie, game 100. Surging the Roar down the pitch. Lincoln able to clear the ball away. And a lovely crowd building here at Perry Park, the traditional and spiritual home of football here in Queensland. Canberra now, here's Heyman. Ground that's held many big fixtures, of course, the home of Brisbane Strikers as well, former NSL club, former NSL winners. Is Scarpelli. Fryer. Down the line for Palmer. Smart movement from Palmer this time. And Cannon Clough able to sweep up for her side. Cannon Clough making her name in Australia, right here in Queensland as well, for Lions FC, a fellow embrace there between two Americans. Mia Corbin starting up top for the Brisbane Roar today. Lions FC, a massive club in the NPL Women's up here in Queensland. And that hill at Perry Park. Not too many better places in Australia to watch football, it must be said. Always a joy to watch the football from there. Here's Woods. Threading it through now, and Chloe Lincoln not troubled by it. Tish Woods, a great story of this season for the Brisbane Roar. Of course, Alex Smith brought her to Peninsula Power from Sunshine Coast Wanderers before the 2022 NPL women's season. But now here's Flannery getting the strike from range, and Keely Richards able to hang on. Great opportunity for her to wear the gloves after the departure of Jordan Silkovitz. There is Tish Woods. Alex Smith bringing her over from Sunshine Coast Wanderers to Peninsula Power, and now bringing her with him, I should say, to the Brisbane Roar, giving her her first opportunity as a professional after he previously teed up trials with Melbourne City in the past. A great opportunity for her. She's taken it with both hands. Coming a full 90-minute player is Clough. pressure from the Roar and just forcing the error. Here's Woods. Managing to get the best of Holly Murray that time. Fryer. A risky ball from the recently called up Matilda, and they do lose possession. Here's Milivojevic, such a star. Trying to thread that ball through. That time for Kristoffersen, can't do so. Here's Kristoffersen. Heyman laying it off for Flannery this time. Cleared by Fryer. Only as far as Kristoffersen. In fact, it is Whittle winning the ball back now, Stevenson. Ilioski. Settling the ship for Canberra United. Here's Murray. Heyman using her physicality very well. No foul given that time. Tamia Corbett. Sarah Clark with a fairly heavy-handed challenge. That's a lovely switch of play. Now the pace this time between Fryer and Flannery. A great matchup there. Here's Palmer. Here's Woods. Dispossessed that time by Milivojevic. Streaming forward now. A strapped right knee. Driving forward. Trying to play the through ball this time for Heyman. And it'll drag wide in the end. Will be a goal kick. Just see that strapping there around the right knee of Milivojevic. Somehow made its way through for Michelle Heyman. And she couldn't get the shot on target. Here's Norrie. Clough. Corbett. Opening things up for herself. Trying to play that ball through for Stevenson this time. And Chloe Lincoln fast off her line to deny the girl from Bundaberg. And Kaya Stevenson. Is Ilioski. Kristoffersen. Intercepted by McQueen. Queensland football running through her blood. There's Holly McQueen. And mum, Pye Augustine, captain and coached Queensland sides in the past. A great story. Here's Holly McQueen. Sold raffle tickets and hosted trivia nights to raise funds to represent Queensland school sports back when she was 12. A trip to Bendigo. Now the opportunity for Stevenson. Moldova. A foul. The ball going the way of Canberra United. Bit of a breakout campaign for Kaya Stevenson as well. Just too heavy-handed that time on Sarah Clark. Was the young winger, Kaya Stevenson. 4 goals this season. Clark. Risky ball across the face that time. Shannon Clough able to collect though. Lovely play from Canberra. Grove. Such a good young player. Doing all the simple things right. Sasha Grove had to fill in at left back last week. Now back to her regular position at right back. English Popovic resting 4 stars last week. She should say, just a few days ago. Wednesday night was the clash, and now ball forward from Stevenson. Such a flashy player. Canberra just edging the possession battle at the moment. Now those four stars for Canberra back in the starting lineup. Milos Popovic did say once they found out they weren't able to make finals anymore, their one goal was really just 9 points from the nine available, and at the moment they're tracking like they will do it. Wins in their last two games. Today is the test whether they can achieve that goal. Scarpelli was a risky ball. Milivojevic couldn't take full advantage, but now can Michelle Heyman. Enough of a touch from Holly McQueen just to deny Jenna McCormick. Michelle Heyman was bearing down. One goal. Holly McQueen did enough. Here's Palmer. Sasha Grove making life difficult. Ilioski. Play the ball through the channel, can't do so. And is picked off by the Brisbane Roar. Scarpelli. Strong addition to the Brisbane Roar this year, has suffered injuries throughout the campaign though. Former Sporting CP player in Portugal. Here's Heyman holding the ball up now. Knows that role so well, does Michelle Heyman. And what a renaissance she's had. Nikki Flannery not happy with her touch that time. It was a nice switch of play. Trying to use that momentum to keep the play going. It's Scarpelli. Raw fans in voice for their last home game, their last game of the season. Ineligible for finals, of course. Now Delahar. Down this right-hand side. Mid-season acquisition. Trying to get the best of Whittle this time. Now the ball towards Mia Corbin, but cut out by Sarah Clark. Heyman and McCormick with a tough battle. On that left-hand side, the ball played forward now, a foot race. Keely Richards able to clear. Just taking her time. She was truly outstanding midweek. The great young goalkeeping prospects in this country. Here's Grove. Driving forward now. Milivojevic, a long way out. Finds the feet of Heyman that time, but the offside flag does go up. It was a nice bit of play. Heyman finding the space well. Different roll without Tamika Yallop today. That's a lovely move from McCormick. That set up Holly Palmer though. Palmer coming in for Tamika Yallop, an able replacement. That's for sure, is Milivojevic. Here's Clough. Handball given against Vesna Milivojevic that time. Couldn't do much about it. Just came out her. Nevertheless, still a handball. McCormick gets us underway quickly. Here's McQueen. Ball forward now. Sarah Clark able to deal with it. It's Clough. Rowe. Flannery, options in the middle this time. That's a great ball from Flannery. Whittle heading it forward this time for Heyman. And Keely Richards out to claim. That's exactly what her side needs her to do. It was a great switch of play by Canberra United, but they can't capitalise. Now, Holly Palmer. Moving forward, Cannon Clough does well. And that is classy from the American, just to evade the pressure. An exit for Canberra United. Here's McCormick. Woods. Numbers forward now for Canberra. McCormick able to head it away. So solid at the back for this Brisbane Roar side. 16 final third entries for Canberra United. Brisbane's 11. Getting in that final third. With a lot more. At the moment, on the balance of things, certainly looking more in control. Corbett. Who's been playing with that three at the back? Scarpelli, Jenna McCormick in the middle, and Holly McQueen on the right hand side. Give you plenty of license for the likes of Della Hart. As well, Sean Fryer to bomb up and down the wings. Here is McQueen. Coming forward now, Milivojevic. Strong challenge from her. Strong but fair. Here's Norrie. Stevenson. Not a bad ball in behind. A little bit short though. Della Harp unable to win it back. Throw in now. Corbin. McQueen. For Norrie. That's a smart ball from McCormick. Able to thread the needle, find Scarpelli, open things up on this left-hand side for the Brisbane Roar. It's intercepted by Grove. Only momentarily. Smart touch from Scarpelli. Just Woods giving away possession. Now McCormick. A marauding run from the centre half. Norrie. Lovely ball in behind. This time Della Harp, and it's intercepted very well by Sarah Clark, but a good foray forward from the Roar. Not over yet. Here's Norrie. Here's Stevenson. Scarpelli. Now Fryer. Marked up by Grove. Fryer to the byline. Can't cut it back for Mia Corbin. Bobby Lincoln able to hang on. Smart from Lincoln. Now Grove. Canberra pouncing on the Brisbane Roar defence. Christofferson this time. And the Roar do enough. A hairy moment for Alex Smith's side. Now Christofferson. Fryer keeping it in play. And draws the foul too. Heads on the plane tomorrow, does Sian Fryer. For her first Matilda's cap. A strong run by Christofferson and the right idea as well. Looking for Michelle Heyman, who's been so potent this year. Here's Lincoln. And what a sight this is. A packed out Perry Park. Full of Brisbane Roar fans. Great location, a great place to watch football. And the ongoing legacy of the 2023 FIFA Women's World Cup. Alive and well. Now Woods driving forward. Find Corbin. And Canberra exit. Not too much difficulty. Now Grove. Getting plenty of action down this right-hand side. Smart turn by Murray. Here's Heyman. Clough. Finding Milivojevic. Here's Murray. Madeline Whittle drawing the foul that time. Tish Woods giving it away. In fact, it was Deborah Ann Della Harp. Gave away the foul, Madeline Whittle. Drew it well as well. And a good opportunity. The Vesna Milivojevic, the Serbian star, to deliver into the box. This has been such a live wire for this Canberra United side. 9 goals, 3 assists. Plenty of green shirts in the box. Namely, number 23, Michelle Heyman. Be lurking at the back post, no doubt. Just discussing what run to make with Sarah Clark. What can they conjure? Just about 24 minutes gone. Milivojevic. All the way through this time. Cleared eventually by Fryer. And it wasn't easy. Fell in an awkward position. Still alive for Canberra. Here's Clough this time. Heyman rising. And will fall to McCormick. Headed away. Corbin. And can Brisbane go the other way? Molly Palmer. Peter punted away and to the sideline in a very awkward position. And luckily for the Brisbane Roar, just fell to Sian Fryer after Michelle Heyman got a touch on it. And not comfortable in the slightest for the Brisbane Roar. Here's Norrie. McCormick sending it long now. A nice switch of play. Fryer. Grove does well. Still alive for Fryer though. That's a strong battle. And great work by Sasha Grove. Great touch by Palmer. Inside now, getting the strike away. Never troubled Chloe Lincoln. Calmly collecting it. 20 minutes to go in this first half. And it's sat up brilliantly for Holly Palmer. That perhaps just not quite enough power, tenacity on it. Made life relatively easy for Chloe Lincoln in the end. Here's McCormick, that's lovely. From the Brisbane Roar. Norrie finding the feet of Corbin now. Fryer out wide. Is this the opportunity? Cleared that time by Flannery. Woods inside this time with the strike. And held on to by Chloe Lincoln. And not a bad effort from Tish Woods, still hunting her first Liberty A-League goal. Smart to shimmy away from the oncoming player. Make an opportunity for herself. Now McCormick chasing. And it is cleared by Brisbane Roar. Is Norrie. Sarah Clark doing the job for Canberra United. Solid at the back today. Is McCormick. Palmer. Now for Fryer. Marked by Flannery. Here's Woods. Scarpelli moving inside this time, having a strike of her own. Perhaps looking for a teammate. Either way, sits in the arms of Chloe Lincoln. Collision that time. Jenna McCormick coming down. No foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face. Mia Corbin with an open goal. And just got caught up in her feet. Can't do anything else but smile in that moment. And that has to be the best opportunity of the game so far. It was a brilliant ball forward from McCormick, and so too by Stevenson. And a nutmeg in the end on Mia Corbin. And that could have and should have been 1-0 Brisbane. Now Canberra will look to go the other way. Heyman can't find the feet. Sophia Christofferson that time. Is Fryer. Is Woods. Just lets it run past her, opening things up for herself. Stevenson. Edge of the box, cuts inside. Palmer on the edge of the box that time, and cleared away by Sasha Grove. Brisbane Roar making their way into this game. And over the last 15 minutes or so, started to regain and maintain possession. 53% now, swinging in their favour. Fryer. Scarpelli. Find the feet of Corbin. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save by Chloe Lincoln. Palms it away with a strong wrist to deny the American Mia Corbin. Did well to cut towards the byline, and a really tight angle for Mia Corbin. Was perhaps going wide anyway. Chloe Lincoln taking no chances. In the first corner of the game. Ishinori standing over it. A delivery now towards that near post, headed away with ease. Woods trying to get a second bite of the cherry for her side. And it does go out of play. Bit of push and shove too between her and Holly Murray. Two young stars in the making. Tish Woods wins out this time. Now Stevenson getting the strike away. Wasn't able to get it down. Sat up well for her. And when it sits up like this, sometimes you just have to have a crack. Not a high percentage opportunity though. The girl from Bundaberg. Sean in the QAS in the NPL up in Queensland. Before moving to Brisbane City. And now it's taking a chance in the Brisbane Roar with two hands. This is lovely from Fryer. Back post now for Corbin. Gets a piece of it but can't get over the top. Now Corbin. Stevenson. Looking for a teammate. Can't find one on the first attempt. Does get to Norrie. Now Stevenson. Out wide for Fryer. Looking to go across the face, and Sasha Groh putting her body on the line. And forcing it to a corner. It was a great ball to that back post. And Mia Corbin just always backtracking. She's been lively in this game and showing exactly why Tony Gustafsson has called her up to that Matilda squad. Holly Palmer standing over the corner now. Ishinori providing the short option. And the Brisbane Roar faithful giving voice to their side. 33 minutes gone. Here's Palmer towards that near post. Falls for Milivojevic, who does clear. Here's McQueen under pressure from Madeline Whittle that time. Palmer. It was a good delivery from the former Melbourne City player. Look for the switch now. That's a great ball in behind for Della Hart. Takes a touch at the byline and does win her side a corner. The Ireland international. And it looks as though it'll go the way of Canberra United in the end. And the right decision just coming off the inside of Della Hart's ankle. Despite being born in Australia, opted to represent the Republic of Ireland. Unfortunately, missed out on their Women's World Cup squad, though. Their first ever appearance at a Women's World Cup is Stevenson. Norrie. This is a lovely play from the Roar. Stevenson in a battle with Clark, and that time the latter wins out. Maya Stevenson, four goals so far this campaign. I mentioned from Bundaberg up north in Queensland, central Queensland really. Used to make the trek twice a week from Bundaberg to Brisbane at the age of 15 to join the QAS. I'll tell you what, it's not an easy journey. Not a short one at all. Here's Della Harp now. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box. Towards the byline. Ishinori. Mia Corbin! And what a save to force it wide. Chloe Lincoln must have got a touch on that. Or it's a goal line clearance. Let's have another look at things. It was great work by Ishinori. Phil, kindly. And what a stop on the line by Sasha Grove by the looks of things. Just to steer it wide. That is brilliant from the fullback, Sasha Grove, the young Matilda. And denies Mia Corbin once more. Perhaps should have had two so far in this game. 10 minutes to play in this first half. Here's Palmer towards the back post this time and headed back towards Chloe Lincoln in an unorthodox fashion. And luckily for Canberra United, they're not made to pay for it. Here's Heyman. Lovely 1-2 for Flannery. Those two connecting so well this season. Madeline Whittle unable to find a teammate. That's a great touch by Milivojevic. Here's Murray. Lifting it into the box now, and Keely Richards sitting under it. Two former teammates with a smile and a jovial greeting. Here's Norrie. Brisbane Roar with six shots in total. Both sides unable to hit the back of the net so far. Now Canberra with the opportunity. Cleared by McCormick. Stevenson. A lively game down that right-hand side. That's brilliant between Corbin and Stevenson. Streaming forward now of the Roar. Clark out to collect. That was really nice play between Stevenson and Corbin. Lovely interplay. And Stevenson didn't have too many options in that attacking third. Sarah Clark alert to the danger. Did very well. Here's De La Harp. Corbett just trying to flick it around the corner, but too much on it. Will be a goal kick. Here's Clough. United just with 45% in terms of passing accuracy in their final third. Just not quite linking up in the best way possible. Just struggling to connect the dots. Christofferson can't find a teammate that time. Brisbane Roar trying to keep it in play. Can't do so. Will be a corner. Canberra's first of the game. A good opportunity for them. With that setting sun as well. Won't be in the eyes of Keely Richards though. And it is a very sunny day here at Perry Park, Bowen Hills. Good part of town. Here in Brisbane, the river not too far away. Now Nikki Flannery standing over it. The delivery now towards that back post, Keely Richards. Able to hang on very well. Just slowed things down for her side. Not a bad ball in from Nikki Flannery at all. Here's Fryer. Skips around Grove that time. Fryer, brilliant challenge by Cannon Clough, a crunching one. And that is brilliant from the American. Now Grove going the other way. Tries to cut inside, but does collide with Holly Palmer. That's class from Fryer. And how about this from Cannon Clough, diving in, doing exactly what she needs to. And the fullback by trade, making a home for herself at centre back. Here's Grove. Heyman can't keep it in play, and it will go the way of the Brisbane Roar. Much to the record holder. No confusion. Here's Richards. Was firmly the Canberra number one for a few years there. Keely Richards. An injury opened up the opportunity for her opposite number today, Chloe Lincoln, at the other end. And boy, did she take it with both hands. Chloe Lincoln just proved why she's such a promising talent and has more than comfortably got that number one jersey for Canberra United. And of course, the voting is open. The A-League Women's All-Stars, the first time ever we'll have an A-League Women's All-Stars side as they take on Arsenal Women's, and what a fixture that'll be. Here's Corbett, just drifting offside. And the voting is open for that A-League All-Stars side. To provide your full 11 as well. And some rising star options. Perhaps Chloe Lincoln, if she's not getting into your first 11.
Yeah, if I can see it.
Might be able to offer a
hardened silhouette in the black and white
as one of those rising star options. More than truly deserving at the moment. Over the last few weeks of her form. Here's Stevenson. Fire out wide now. Winner's side, a corner. Great an opportunity. Here's Palmer. Finding the feet of Tish Woods. Does get her side the corner in the end. The Canberra-born player, Tish Woods. Making a name for herself for the Brisbane Roar. Given the opportunity by Alex Smith, and will no doubt in future squads be looking at getting into that young Matilda squad. And it'll be a great journey for her. She's impressed so much in the NPL Women's over the last few years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post, bundled in by Jenna McCormick. Engaged today, kisses the ring finger. And opens the scoring for the Roar. What a day for Jenna McCormick. A dream come true. It was a great delivery. And a brilliantly timed run by Jenna McCormick to that back post, a glancing header. And they open the scoring. Brisbane Roar have been rotating. Whoever's taking that corner kick, and Jenna McCormick says thank you very much and points to her partner and now fiance Hannah Holgerson and flexes to the crowd. One nil Brisbane, and Canberra have to reply. A good time for the Roar to score as well, right before the halftime break. Always good to go into the sheds with a goal. Will be 1 minute added on here at Perry Park. Norrie. Flannery working down that left-hand side now. Here's Norrie. Palmer. Smart ball over the time, and in fact 2 minutes added on here at Perry Park. Scarpelli, Woods, Norrie, in behind now, Della Harp, back this time and offside is the call. Throw in now for the Brisbane Roar. Here's McCormick. Down the line. Kept in play. Now Della Harp. One back by Canberra United. Holly Murray. Able to win it back for her side. Here's Grove. Lifting it in. Can't find the feet of Sophia Christofferson. And Brisbane will go the other way. Clough. Here's Grove now. Christofferson. Around Scarpelli. Cutting back towards the direction of Michelle Heyman, but it is cleared by Jenna McCormick. Has been so good today. Now Corbin. Can they get another the Roar? Stevenson forced out wide. Here's Norrie, and that will be halftime here at Perry Park. The Brisbane Roar leading at the break. Thanks to that player right there, Jenna McCormick, rising from the corner right before the halftime break. An end-to-end first half. Brisbane Roar lead at the break. Michelle Heyman with plenty of conversations with Njegosh Popovic. But it is Brisbane Roar 1, Canberra United 0. Well, it was a big first half. Kaya Stevenson helping to open things up. What an opportunity miss that was for the Brisbane Roar. Mia Corbin arriving at the back post. Chloe Lincoln not able to shut it down. Mia Corbin may go to rue that opportunity. She created one for herself right here. What a stop by Chloe Lincoln. Lovely bit of footwork from the number nine. And Chloe Lincoln showing every bit of her class in that moment. Ish Norrie in game 100, pulling the strings. And what a stop by Sasha Grove, a goal line clearance to keep her side in it. Plenty of opportunities for Mia Corbin in this game. Yet to hit the back of the net. But how about this? Jenna McCormick rising from the corner. Nestling it into that bottom corner. A great delivery from Deborah Ann Della Harp. And the celebration. Kissing the engagement ring she got earlier today. And a very happy day for her indeed. Halftime stats, Brisbane Roar leading the possession battle. Getting plenty of shots on target as well. Making it a tough day in the office for Chloe Lincoln. And bar that one corner, the young goalkeeper has stood up to the test. An exciting first half here at Perry Park, and an even more exciting second stanza to come. Stick with us.
ball and they'll dribble it back. First one to score wins the prize, which is a Wooler merchandise pack and event centre's double pass today. All right. Do we have a thumbs up from our contestants here today? Yes, we've got thumbs up from everyone. All right. On your marks. Get set. Go. Here we go. The Egan Spoon Race. Oh, look at Anna. She is there in the front. Oh, keeping hold. We've had a drop. We've had a drop here. Tora drops over on the left-hand side. That's all right. Anna is absolutely carving this one up. Getting up there with the, I think you can see, oh, we've got a drop. All right, we're picking it up. Here we go. Anna's got up. The mare always, there we go, Anna. You've got to get it. Drill that ball down. You get it into the goal. Oh, Anna. Well, here we go. This, oh, it's a tough run now. Here we go. This is going to be real close. First one to get it in the goal. Anna's got it. There we go. Well done, everyone. You all walk away with a prize. Anna, congratulations. We've got the Royal Merchandise Pack, and you get yourself an event centre's double pass. How do you feel about that? What's the score going to be for the rest of the game here with ADT? 4-0 works. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. Please give a big round of applause to our contestants here today. Our winner, Anna. We've got Mia, Olivia, Millie and Tora as well.
Shakes the lambs, don't give it down. When the night's here, I don't feel tears, baby. Bye.
And don't forget to join us at the end of the game today, because we will be celebrating Ish Norrie's 100 games for the Brisbane Roar, and we're going to be doing a big club photo at the southern end, which we ask you all to stay around and take part in as well. So make sure you join us at the end of today's game, the last one for the Liberty A-League for this season.
Would you rather be on your Saturday afternoon than right there, Perry Park Hill, watching the Brisbane Roar play Canberra United in the final Liberty A-League game of the season, or the final round, I should say, the final Brisbane Roar home game of the campaign. And what a first half it has been here at Perry Park. Mia Corbett with an opportunity at a tight angle to open the scoring. She had a few opportunities in that first half, did the American. Wasn't able to capitalise on them. Chloe Lincoln, once again, being stellar between the sticks. How about this for a stop on the goal line? Mia Corbin with the strike. Sasha Grove getting enough on it to steer it wide. And exactly what her side needed. But the scoring open from this opportunity right here. Deborah Ann Delahart with the delivery. Jenna McCormick dispatching a lovely glance header into the side netting. Exactly what the Brisbane Roar needed. And what a day it has been for Jenna McCormick. Got engaged earlier today to fellow teammate Hannah Holgerson. And now scoring her third goal of the campaign. The defender leading by example at the back for the Brisbane Roar. Canberra United, well, they're mainly on the hunt for a record for Michelle Heyman. Neither side today able to make finals in what is shaping up to be a truly exciting final few days of the Liberty A-League season. Very, very chaotic indeed. Unfortunately for both of these sides, they won't be part of the festivities. But tomorrow night, tomorrow afternoon, you'd have to be tuned in to the Liberty A-League as Sydney FC host Melbourne Victory in a big blue clash that may just decide the premiership. As well, Melbourne City taking on Perth Glory. In what, if Sydney FC don't get a result, will certainly decide the premiership, I should say. And Shaan Fryer, how good has she been in this first half? The recently called up Matilda, her maiden call up. And today, she's putting on a show and showing exactly why Tony Gustafsson has selected her. And we are back underway for the second half here at Perry Park, the home of the Brisbane Strikers. A great ground as a fan. Players love it too, as well as coaches. Spoke to Alex Smith prior to this evening's game. He said, love playing here. They've made it a fortress in recent times, have the Brisbane Roar. Only lost one of their last five A-League women's matches at Perry Park. Three wins, one draw, including two wins against Perth Glory and Melbourne City. Their last two matches at the venue. Of course, Canberra United making their way forward now. The delivery. Keely Richards out to claim against her former side. The former side who've certainly had the wood over the Brisbane Roar in recent memory. Unbeaten in their last six matches against the Brisbane Roar. Two wins and four draws across that time. It's been a long time since the Brisbane Roar got the win over Canberra United. Here's McCormick. Both sides looking to end the season on a high. Is De La Harp. Stevenson. Out wide now for Scarpelli. The American centre half lifted in this time for Corbin. Getting the volley away. And it looked threatening. It just went all the way across the face. And she's having a busy afternoon. Here's the Seattle native. It was a good strike. Just too much of that side footing rather than putting the laces through it. She has been a joy to watch at points this year. Mia Corbett, 8 goals, 4 assists. Good addition for this Brisbane Roar side. Is Scarpelli. Big news overnight as well from a former Brisbane Roar player. We'll get to that in just a moment. Corbin now cutting it back this time, and Holly Palmer unable to get onto the end of it. Larissa Crummer, the news I was speaking about earlier, former Brisbane Roar player, Tawantin. Born and raised up on the Central Coast, or I should say Sunshine Coast, has announced her retirement at just 28 years of age. Been playing over in Europe for SK Brann. He exited the Champions League to the hands of Barcelona and has since announced her retirement, deciding that she wants to come back home to her wife and 2 kids and be a plumber. And she is by trade. Focus on that, focus on family life. An early retirement for a Matilda. You never know what will happen though. We may see a return at one stage. This is lovely from Michelle Heyman. Skipping past Scarpelli that time. Heyman getting the strike away. And just hitting the advertising board, not forcing a save out of Keely Richards. She made it all by herself, did Michelle Heyman. She couldn't hit the back of the net. Now the opportunity once more for Canberra. Given away by the Roar. The strike this time, rifling off the crossbar. And Michelle Heyman can't follow it up. Leah Scarpelli just saying, let's settle it down. And it fell so kindly. Right here for Sarah Clark. Skip pass one in Jenna McCormick. And it absolutely cannoned off the crossbar. Here's Christofferson. Here is Clark. Clough, one back by the Roar, here's Corbin. It was good work from Holly Palmer that time. Sarah Clark to the aid of her side. Scarpelli with the throw-in. Scarpelli now, lifting it in behind, this time for Norrie. Can't quite keep it in play. And it will be a goal kick. Nice run from the captain in game 100. Here's Clark. Not a bad ball forward, can't find a teammate though. Norrie. Fryer, Grove, the ball in now towards Corbin. Stevenson trying to make something of it. Here's Woods. De La Harp dispossessed and gives away the foul. Green. there. Della Harp just holding on to the arm of Madeline Whittle. Foul every day of the week. McCormick able to clear. Brisbane Roar haven't managed to beat Canberra United since the 23rd of February 2020. If you do your maths, it's 1,497 days since their last win over Canberra. As things stand, they are in the lead. What a result that would be. Nicky Flannery fouled that time by Sian Fryer. Sees yellow for her efforts as well. Bit of frustration setting in. Was just lost the ball. Pulled back Nicky Flannery. Clear as day. Just frustration from the newest Matilda. What an opportunity it is for her to get into that Matilda squad. Great opportunity. The ball now from Clark. Headed away by McQueen that time. Here's Palmer. Just knocking it around Clark at Sasha Grove. Such a professional. Coming to her side's rescue. And what a player Sasha Grove is. It's been so good for Canberra United today and across the course of the season. Really coming into her own at a club that means so much to her. Being a member of the Canberra United Academy since she was 10. Here's Flannery. McQueen. And Whittle chasing her down, and that's a smart ball from Ish Norrie. Brisbane Roar playing some good football. And a heavy collision that time. And Kate Jakovic will have a look at it. Perhaps a head clash between Holly Murray and Ish Norrie, and it wasn't pretty upon contact here. Holly Murray straight down. Not what you like to see at all. Perhaps just that knee causing a little bit of issues for Holly Murray. Hopefully she is okay. Just getting the testing from the physios. In a bit of pain. Perhaps the wind knocked out of her slightly. Had a good game so far today, has Holly Murray. This isn't the way you'd want to see it ended. In her second season now with the club is Holly Murray. She's signed off the back of a strong NPL Victoria campaign with South Melbourne. A young player. And she will be subbed off. Holly Murray, a double change for Canberra United. Alex McKenzie coming on for her. Tegan Bertolizio to come on as well. And despite Emma Ilioski still being there, he's getting ready to come off. A double change to be made. And a round of applause for her, Holly Murray. Hopefully nothing long-term for her. You can see the pain she's in. Hopefully not a major setback. She is up and walking. Shouldn't be too long. The end of the season now as well. But a double change, Tegan Bertolizio.
Substitution for Canberra United.
And as well, Alex McKenzie coming on. Emma Ilioski making way. Double change for Njegosz Popovic. Will that make the difference for them? Alex McKenzie, a strong role last week. Wednesday evening, I should say. against Sydney FC. Started in that game. All of the outfield substitutes today did start in that game, of course. Jenna McCormick just getting the lay of the land from Kate Jakovic. And we are back underway at Perry Park. Of course, our time will be added on later in the game. Here's McQueen. Just able to win her side the throw-in. Wasn't much doing ahead of her. And it truly is great to see such a healthy crowd here at Perry Park, and I'm sure all Liberty A-League teams will end the season strong this weekend, Easter weekend. No better time to get around it. And strong that time from Tegan Bertolizio, just holding her ground. Fairly and all. Just to shove off Kaya Stevenson. Here's Lincoln now. Sent long towards halfway. Christofferson. One by McQueen. Here's Delahar. Bertolizio, the substitute down the line. McKenzie under pressure, slotting in to that central defensive midfield role, and Tish Woods bundled over, but no foul given. Bertolizio, looking that time for Heyman, and coming in was Christofferson. Jenna McCormick doing just enough. Keep it away from her path. Jenna McCormick still down. That's one back this time by Flannery. Here's Milivojevic. Making away to the byline this time. And Keely Richards able to hang on. Does very well. That's Keely Richards. Now Flannery, looking to add her eighth assist of the campaign. Can't do it that time. Just about 60 minutes gone in this one. Half an hour to play. Half an hour of these two teams' seasons left. Here's Corbin. Intercepted this time by Milivojevic. Ball forward now. Here's Heyman. Grove, a marauding run from the fullback. It's Leah Scarpelli getting her head in the way, feeling it a little bit too. But it saves her side in that moment. Sasha Grove just trying to cross it in. And coming off the back of Leah Scarpelli's head. A little bit worse for wear afterwards. She will be fine. You can see the banner that time for Ishinori. One of the fan favourites here at Perry Park and for the Brisbane Roar. And delivery now. Takes a touch on its way through and it will be sent out of play by Tish Woods. Flannery delivering, this time for Canberra United. Falling to the edge of the box. The strike that time by Clark. He's blocked. And Brisbane Roar do clear their lines. It's Bertolizio. A hopeful launch forward from the young fullback. It's Palmer. Norrie. Can't link up. With Palmer that time, sent forward now. Keely Richards just able to collect. Start things back up for her side. Scarpelli, that ball down the line. Bundled over after the play, no foul given. Will be a throw in the way of Canberra. Milivojevic, lovely touch inside from the Serbian. The ball forward now, and Keely Richards launching it long. Here's Nori. Heavy collision that time with Milivojevic. They play on though. Now the ball at the feet of Heyman. McKenzie. It's Bertolizio. Great ball inside, this time for Heyman. Skips around one, finding that time off the crossbar. And Sofia Christofferson rifling it off the woodwork and had a wide open Michelle Heyman. Well, that was lovely from Michelle Heyman, and had that option in the middle and points to it. Why didn't you play it to me? It comes off the woodwork. And that's the second time for Canberra United. And a golden opportunity once more goes begging. Michelle Heyman, she could have equaled Sam Kerr's record of 17 goals in a season. In that moment right there, not given the opportunity. Is Woods. Fryer. Great challenge that time by Nori. The foul given the way of Milivojevic. The Serbian just having a few words about it. A change to be made as well. The foul perhaps just given for that lingering challenge from Ish Nori. Hecker getting ready to come on for the Brisbane Roar. Such an exciting player to watch is the Brazilian. Sarah Clark standing over the free kick, a long way out now. Opportunity to find a teammate. And that hill does look fantastic here at Perry Park. Played short down the line that time. Bit heavy though. Does go out of play. Sasha Grove can't wrangle it in. A change being made now. Mariel Hecker coming on. Kaya Stevenson making way. And a fan favourite, Mariel Hecker, back into the fray for the Roar. Has battled with injury for some time now, and a massive ovation for Kaya Stevenson. Mariel Hecker, a massive ovation for her too. Such a fun player to watch. And into the fray for the Brisbane Roar now. A heavy one that time. Player down in Scarpelli. And a tough one to take for her. Hopefully she's okay. And you heard the grimace from the crowd. And in some pain in that moment. And a tough one for her. To have a look back from this angle. Took the ball down. Trying to clear it right there. And just a late collision, perhaps the hip just over-rotated. Looks like she will be able to continue. Just an agricultural challenge, perhaps. Either way, she will be okay. The American, and a good addition to this side. This campaign has Leah Scarpelli. And she just has a laugh about it. Wondering when she can return. She is able to do so. We are back underway. Here's McQueen. She's been doing the simple things right this afternoon. Nice ball in for Corbett. Here's Hecker. Her first involvement of the game. Woods. This is lovely now. Norrie with a heavy touch that time. Can't keep it within arm's reach. Now, here's Christofferson. Can she centre it this time? Bursting past McCormick, who does well. Does manage to make its way inside, but held on to by Keely Richards. Here's Whittle. Over the top this time for McKenzie. Cutting inside. McQueen intercepting. Going to go the other way to Bertolizio. One back well. Here's Whittle. Lifted in behind. Nice little dink. No foul given either. Here's Milivojevic having a crack from a long way out. Not quite hit the way she was after. Here's McCormick. Hecker, the wind picking up here at Perry Park. Corbett. Cutting inside now, the American getting the strike away. And always going wide. Here's Clark. Well dealt with by Holly McQueen. A good turn from her as well, skipping through traffic. Does manage to find Sian Fryer. Is Norrie. Switching the play. Now Della Harp. And the offside flag does go up on the Republic of Ireland international. Former Sydney FC and Perth Glory player, of course. Deborah Ann Della Harp. One of their triumphs last year at Sydney FC. That's nice from the Roar. Della Harp trying to burst forward and Cannon Clough to her side's rescue. It's a lovely touch by Whittle. Just about 70 minutes gone here at Perry Park. Hecker out wide. Della Harp cutting inside now, the fullback getting the strike away this time. Can't beat Chloe Lincoln. It was a nice move from the Roar. Della Harp moving inside that time. The angle closed off by Sarah Clark. Far too hard to make anything of it. Here's Flannery. Bertolizio over the top this time. McCormick heading it down only into the path of Milivojevic. Falling over that time was Norrie. Tish Woods able to handle it for the Brisbane Roar. Mish Norrie in game 100, of course. Been told she'll be awarded with some crystal after the game. Bit of glassware engraved with the club and game 100 as a thank you to her service to the league and to the club. A nice gesture from the Brisbane Roar. She'll be presented with it full time in front of the crowd. Here's Fryer. Corbin. Woods. It's a good ball forward from Tish Woods, but Tegan Bertolizio to intercept it. Not under much pressure either. Well controlled by Whittle. McCormick, a risky ball. Not a bad one though, just to evade the pressure. Fryer having that battle on that far side with Flannery, and she wins out brilliantly. Sian Fryer. A lovely move. Putting Alex McKenzie down as well. This is brilliant down this left-hand side. The ball in now. Chloe Lincoln hangs on. A move like that deserved a goal at the end of it. A lovely bit of play from Sian Fryer and the Brisbane Roar. Here's Palmer. Cutting inside now. Brisbane Roar readying the substitutes once more. Beck Kirkham getting ready to come on. Deborah Della Harp perhaps making way. Here's Palmer. Finding Corbin. Options in the middle. This is good football from the Roar. Woods. Finding Hecker. Out wide now. Della Harp. Not bad. And Madeline Whittle. A bit of sand away. Not taking any chances. Is the youngster. Confirmation of that change on the far side. Deborah Ann Della Harp making way. Rebecca Kirkham coming on, the former Lions FC player. And a personal trainer by day. Awarded with her first professional contract at the age of 30 this season. Which you simply love to see. Has been such a stalwart of that Lions FC side over the last few years. Up here in the MPLW Queensland. Here's Woods. Kirker. Woods does well. And it's sent out of play once more. A throw in again for the Brisbane Roar. About 16 minutes to play. Kirker, nice throw in now. Mario Hecker can't get onto the end of it. Will be a goal kick, Chloe Lincoln to take. Another change being made on that far side.
Substitution for Canberra United, number 19, Nicoletta Flannery replaced.
Canberra making the change, Nikki Flannery coming off. Devin Jackson coming on. She's had a good day, has Nikki Flannery. But it comes to a close, her season comes to a close. Here's Hecker. In now for Kirker. The delivery towards that near post that time, and Sarah Clark, happy to send it away. Woods. For Kirker. At the byline now. Cuts inside, almost goes down. And it is cleared away. And a yellow card shown. That time seemingly to Sarah Clark. A player down in Ishinori.
Don't forget to get your last votes in for the Brisbane Roar player of the match. You can do that now at the Brisbane
Roar. Game 100.
5 minutes to finish up with those votes.
I hope that's not the end of her day, end of her season. Not the way you want to wrap up game 100, being subbed off due to injury. Still got two outfield substitutes to the Brisbane Roar, Tamar Levin and Bonnie Davies. Vesna Milivojevic has been so good this season, especially to start the campaign, was absolutely on fire. Confirmation of that change as well. Devin Jackson now into the fray. Thank you, Flannery. The day comes to an end. And it looks like Ishinori will be able to continue. The captain. Which is great to see. Play will reset. Vesna Milivojevic, one of the ones that got away for the Matildas, perhaps. opting to play for Serbia. Is Woods just offside that time? Flag goes up. Just over 14 minutes left in both sides' seasons. Can Canberra have one last hurrah? Can the Brisbane Roar end strong? Can they get their first win over Canberra? In nearly 1,500 days. Be a great result for them. And the perfect way to end the season, and end the season strong as they have done, is Clark. A lifting ball into the box now. Falls down, cleared though by the Brisbane Roar. Here's Palmer. Down that left-hand side, one back by Canberra. Fryer under pressure from Milivojevic. Here's Norrie. Palmer. Back inside for Norrie now. Brisbane Roar working this left-hand side quite well so far in this game. Here's McQueen. Driving out of defence. The centre back in that final third now, and the run by Beck Kirker just held up. Confirmation of the attendance today. Over 2,800 people at Perry Park. A fantastic turnout on a beautiful Saturday afternoon here at Perry Park. And a great sign of where our league is at. Is Hecker. Clough trying to clear it. Canberra just struggling to clear their lines. Here's Woods. Feeding it in behind. That's a great ball for Fryer now. Saved by Lincoln and cleared by Cannon Clough. Here's Woods. Sasha Grove with a heavy challenge. Fryer. Palmer. Cutting inside now. Here's Fryer. Sasha Grove has done a great job at right back today. Fryer once more. Intercepted that time by McKenzie. A brilliant challenge by McCormick. Devin Jackson opening things for Milivojevic though. Looking to move forward for Canberra. Can they have one last hurrah? Or trying to flick on by Heyman, and a foul blown up on Jenna McCormick. Madeline Whittle drawing it. Slightly delayed, but in a very dangerous area. Let's have a look back at this now. Nick Kirkett perhaps, just with the late contact. And very soft for mine. Madeline Whittle just getting a little bit tripped up. Whether Beck Kirkup maybe just hit that back leg. Tough to see from this angle. Either way, it is a foul. At the edge of the box, a free kick. Vesna Milivojevic standing over it, who's been so good this season. 9 goals to her name. The Serbian, the star for Canberra United. A deadly range. A packed out Perry Park Hill. Vesna Milivojevic standing over it, striking, dragging it wide with under 10 minutes to play here at Perry Park. Not a bad effort though, getting up and down. Keely Richards never stressed by it. Physical now from Sarah Clark. Finding the feet this time of Milivojevic, coming alive at this late point, this late juncture. Vesna Milivojevic skying it over the bar at the death, and you can see her frustration. She did so well to get in that position. Beats one. Beats two. And can't deliver the final blow. Looked as though it might be sailing into that top right-hand corner. But it was always rising from the Serbian. And Canberra back on the charge. You can see her frustration. What a way that would be to cap off your season, keep your side alive in the game. Not that the result means too much, but of course, the building blocks for next campaign. Here's Jackson. It comes off. Devin Jackson last will be a Brisbane Roar goal kick. Two goals for the campaign, Devin Jackson. And have a look at that. Telling the tale of the tape today. Brisbane Roar 64% shooting accuracy. Canberra United just 11%. They've hit the bar twice. Skied it over a few times. And if they were just a few inches different, then today's scoreline would tell a whole different story. Here's Milivojevic once more. Marked by Fryer. First time delivery. Ariel Hecker clearing only as far as Devin Jackson this time. And Brisbane Roar struggling to get rid. They do in the end. There will be a throw-in. Sasha Grove taking it quickly. The intensity picking up late in this game. Canberra want to get it back level. Here's Clark. Finding the feet of Madeline Whittle. Does well to beat two that time. Now for Heyman, takes the touch and puts it away. Who else but Michelle Heyman? She equals Sam Kerr's record of 17 goals in a season and saves Canberra once more. A poacher's finish. She did exactly what she had to do and it had been coming for Canberra. Takes the touch and puts it into the bottom corner off the post. And captain, fantastic. Their final game of the season. And the Golden Boot winner, all but sealed up. What a player. Equaling Sam Kerr's record. Back in 2018-19 of 17 total goals in a campaign. Well, she's equaled it. And there's still time. Still time for her to eclipse Sam Kerr. And what a moment that would be. Of course, a longer season than when Sam Kerr set the record. Sam Kerr truly in a league of her own, but an opportunity for Michelle Heyman to snatch back the record. Here's Milivojevic driving forward now and finding its way in. And this game has turned on its head out of nowhere. What is happening at Perry Park? Vesna Milivojevic hits double figures, her 10th of the campaign. And wow, Vesna Milivojevic driving forward through the legs of Keely Richards. And Canberra United have completely turned it around. 4, simply incredible. Who could have seen this coming? And Canberra United ending the season in style and as they have done all season long as the great entertainers of the competition. And a few changes being made late here at Perry Park. Mia Corbin making way. And wow, two goals in 2 minutes. and turning this fixture on its head. You could not write this stuff. Wow. Ruby Nathan now on as well for Canberra United. And is there more late drama to come here at Perry Park? Here's Kirker. Edge of the box now, Tish Woods. The turn from Tamar Levin now onto the field. Bonnie Davies as well. A double change for the Brisbane Roar. Sian Fryer in the corner. Can't keep it in play, but does win her side the throw-in. And this game, well, it may have just about 2 minutes to play, but it's far from over. Tamar Levin. Here's Hecker. McQueen looking for that incisive ball through the back line. Here's Heyman. She wants more outside of the boot for Nathan now. Driving forward. Cutting inside. Looking for options. It's blocked by the Brisbane Roar. The crowd getting around their side. Lovely move from Milivojevic. Going down was Levin. Here's Milivojevic. Heading towards the corner flag, just as they did midweek. And what a run of form this has been for Canberra United at the back end of the year. Beating Sydney FC midweek to deny them the premiership. And snatching the victory at the death here at Perry Park against the Brisbane Roar. Christopherson, lovely turn. Canberra just happy to keep it in this corner. Two goals from just three shots on target. The shooting percentage very low for Canberra. Here's McCormick. A wrestle in the center of the park. Here's Clough, looking for victory against her former side. Bertolicio, kept in play that time by Nathan. Clark. Ball forward now, Tish Woods. Unable to keep it close to her. And I'll tell you what, there'll be still a bit of action in this game. 6 minutes to be added on here at Perry Park. There's still time. There's still time for Brisbane to get back into it. And there's still time for Michelle Heyman to set yet another record. She's equaled Sam Kerr's goals in a season record. And of course, last week, she broke the goals and assist record. Now on 98 goals for Canberra United. What a player. And there's still work to be done. Aging like a fine wine is Michelle Heyman, showing no signs of slowing down. Here's Clark. Driving out of defence, Bertolicio. Clark. Back for Clough now. Canberra taking their time. Just trying to hold on to the ball. Not give the Brisbane Roar any opportunity to level things. Scarpelli. Roar backward possession. What can they conjure? What rabbit can they pull out of the hat to turn things around? Make this game even more chaotic. They give the ball away. Lincoln out wide. Grove. Ball played forward by Jackson. Is Christofferson keeping it in play? Marked by McCormick. Sophia Christofferson, they'll want to keep it in this corner now. And going down was Sophia Christofferson. Perhaps looking for that foul. Not given on the far side. Sophia Christofferson. Definitely looking for the foul on that occasion. And not given by Avril Beecham on the far side. Here's Grove now. Down towards the corner flag. Christofferson. One back by Fryer and the Brisbane Roar. 11. The Roar keeping it in play but giving away the ball. Body's flying everywhere at the moment. Is Scarpelli sending it long. Still Milivojevic down for Canberra United. Here's Levin. Back up now. And just hopping on that right leg. Bit of trouble perhaps in that knee that she does have strapped up. And it's one back this time by Ruby Nathan. A big opportunity now for Michelle Heyman. Blocked on the line. Scarpelli denying a bit of history. Michelle Heyman can't believe her luck. What could have been was a great ball by Ruby Nathan, and just off balance anywhere else. And Michelle Heyman is looking at yet another record. Here's Lincoln clearing. Straight for Bet Kirker. Hecker can't put it around her. And it does keep in play. Here's Clark. No chances taken. Just 2 minutes to play. Neither side can make finals. That doesn't mean there's nothing on the line. Roar. They want their first win over Canberra United in 1,497 days. Canberra United. They want to hold out. They want to get Michelle Heyman yet another record, her second of the week. Still plenty to play for. Here's McQueen. Kirker under pressure. Coming off Bertolizio. Here's McQueen now. Denied by Heyman. Another throw in for the Brisbane Roar. Hecker. Two former Lions FC players linking up that time. Woods almost brought down and does draw the foul. He's had a solid game so far as Tish Woods. Perhaps just caught late by Tegan Bertolizio. And they need this now, the Brisbane Roar. Under a minute to play. Under a minute for them to pull level. And boy, do they need it. Here's Hecker. Low ball that time. Devin Jackson able to head it away. Scarpelli keeping it in the field of play momentarily before winning her side the throw in. Scarpelli cutting inside now. 11. Hecker. 11 won't be able to keep it in play. And that is full time between Brisbane and Canberra. And for both of these sides, season. Somehow, Canberra United pull it back right at the death. To get the win, thanks to that player right there, Michelle Heyman. Equaling Sam Kerr's single season goal record as it ends at Perry Park. Brisbane Roar 1, Canberra United 2. What a game that was in game 100 for Each Norrie. Jenna McCormick able to head it by glancing header to open the scoring in that first half, right before halftime. Kisses the engagement ring. Got engaged earlier today. Points to her now fiance. And how about this? Michelle Heyman doing what Michelle Heyman does best. A true striker's goal. 17 for the season. Equal record with Sam Kerr that she set back in 2018-19 season. And what a campaign it's been for Michelle Heyman. Setting up Vesna Milivojevic here as well. Driving into the box and causing absolute mayhem at Perry Park. Two goals, 2 minutes, with less than 4 minutes on the clock to turn the fixture completely on its head. And one last hurrah for Canberra United for the season. Brisbane Roar with plenty of opportunities in this game. More possession, more shots on target. And what a game of football that was here at Perry Park. Exciting right till the end as both sides sign off for the season. Brisbane Roar with their last fixture, and so too Canberra as Holly Murray cartwheels out of the season. It ends at Perry Park. Brisbane Roar 1, Canberra United 2. She moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin! Forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin! And goal! And just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box towards the byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. And what a save to Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back. Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post. Bundle. Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post. Bundled in by Jenna McCormick. Engaged today. Kisses the ring finger and opens the score. Foul though, and she moves the ball forward now for Stevenson across the face. Mia Corbin forward now for Stevenson across the face. Mia Corbin win goal and just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting. Now the opportunity once more for Canberra. Given away by the Roar. The strike this time. Rifling off the crossbar. Now the opportunity once more for Canberra. Given away by the Roar. The strike this time. Rifling off the crossbar. And Michelle Heyman can't follow it up. Leah Scarpelli playing some good football. And a heavy collision that time. And Kate Jackman. Great ball inside. This time for Heyman. Skips around one. Finding that time off the cross. This time for Heyman. Skips around one. Finding that time. This time for Heyman. Skips around one. Finding that time off the crossbar. And Sophia Christofferson. A big opportunity. Now for Michelle Heyman. A big opportunity. Now for Michelle Heyman. Blocked on the line. No foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face. Mia Corbin. Forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face. Mia Corbin. Win goal. And just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go. Foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face. Mia Corbin. Forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face. Mia Corbin. Win goal. And just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box towards the byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. Byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. Byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. And what a save to Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back. Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post. Bundle. Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post. Bundled in by Jenna McCormick. In foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face. Mia Corbin. Forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face. Mia Corbin. Win goal. And just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box towards the. Now the opportunity once more for Canberra. Given away by the Roar. The strike this time. Rifling off the crossbar. Now the opportunity once more for Canberra. Given away by the Roar. rifling off the crossbar, and Michelle Heyman can't follow it up. Leah Scarpelli just saying, let's settle it down. And it fell so kindly right here for Sarah Clark. Skip pass one in Jenna McCormick. And it absolutely cannoned off the crossbar. Here's Christofferson. Here is Clark. Clough. One back by the Roar. Here's Corbin. It was good work from Holly Palmer that time. Sarah Clark to the aid of her side. Scarpelli with the throw in. Scarpelli now lifting it in behind. This time for Norrie. Can't quite keep it in play. And it will be a goal kick. Nice run from the captain. In game 100, here's Clark. Not a bad ball forward, can't find a teammate though. Norrie. Now Fryer. Grove. The ball in now towards Corbin Stevenson. Trying to make something of it, here's Woods. Dillahart. Now the opportunity once more for Canberra. Given away by the Roar. The strike this time. Rifling off the crossbar. Now the opportunity once more for Canberra. Given away by the Roar. The strike this time. Rifling off the crossbar. And Michelle Heyman can't follow it up. Leah Scarpelli playing some good football. Playing some good football. And a head side. And Kate Jakovic will have a look at it. Perhaps a head clash between Holly Murray and Ish Norrie, and it wasn't pretty upon contact here. And Holly Murray straight down. Not what you like to see at all. And perhaps just that knee causing a little bit of issues for Holly Murray. Hopefully she is okay. Just getting the testing from the physios. In a bit of pain, perhaps the wind knocked out of her slightly. She's had a good game so far today, has Holly Murray. This isn't the way you'd want to see it ended. In her second season now with the club is Holly Murray. Signed off the back of a strong NPL Victoria campaign with South Melbourne. A young player. No foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin! Forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin! Good goal! And just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box towards the byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline, Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline, Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. And what a save to Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back. Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back post. Bundle. Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back post. Bundled in by Jenna McCormick. Engaged today. Kisses the ring finger. And opens the score. No foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin. Forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin. Open goal. And just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box. Towards the byline. Ish Norrie. Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie. Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie. Mia Corbin. And what a save to Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back. Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back post. Bundle. Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back post. Bundled in by Jenna McCormick. Engaged today. Kisses the ring finger. And opens the score. No foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin. Forward. Stevenson across the face, Mia Corbin. Open goal, and just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box. Towards the byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. And what a save to Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back. Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back post. Bundle. Years. Here's De La Harp now. Towards that back post. Bundled in by Jenna McCormick. And opens the score. No foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin. Forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin. open goal and just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box towards the byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. And what a save to years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post. Bundled in by Jenna McCormick. Engaged today. Kisses the ring finger and opens the score. Bertolizio. Great ball inside, this time for Heyman. Skips around one, finding that time off the crossbar. And Sophia Christofferson rifling it off the woodwork and had a wide open Michelle Heyman. Well, that was lovely from Michelle Heyman, and had that option in the middle and points to it. Why didn't you play it to me? It comes off the woodwork. And that's the second time for Canberra United. And a golden opportunity once more goes begging. Michelle Heyman, she could have equaled Sam Kerr's record of 17 goals in a season. In that moment right there, not given the opportunity. Is Woods. Fryer. Great challenge that time by Norrie. A foul given the way of Milivojevic. The Serbian just having a few words about it. A change to be made as well. A foul perhaps just given for that lingering challenge from Ish Norrie. Hecker getting ready to come on for the Brisbane Roar. Such an exciting player to watch is the Brazilian. Sarah Clark standing over the free kick, a long way out now. Opportunity to find a teammate. And that hill does look fantastic here at Perry Park. Played short down the line that time. Bit heavy though. Does go out of play. Sasha Grove can't wrangle it in. A change being made now. Mariel Hecker coming on. Kaya Stevenson making way. And a fan favourite, Mariel Hecker, back into the fray for the Roar. Has battled with injury for some time now, and a massive ovation for Kaya Stevenson. Mariel Hecker, a massive ovation for her too. Such a fun player to watch. And into the fray for the Brisbane Roar now. A heavy one that time. Player down in Scarpelli. And a tough one to take for her. Hopefully she's okay. And you heard the grimace from the crowd. And in some pain in that moment. And a tough one for her. To have a look back from this angle. Took the ball down. Trying to clear it right there. And just a late collision, perhaps the hip just over rotated. Looks like she will be able to continue. Just an agricultural challenge, perhaps. Either way, she will be okay. The American, and a good addition to this side. This campaign has Leah Scarpelli. And she just has a laugh about it. Wondering when she can return. She is able to do so. We are back underway. Here's McQueen. She's been doing the simple things right this afternoon. Nice ball in for Corbett. Here's Hecker. Her first involvement of the game. Woods. This is lovely now. Norrie with a heavy touch that time. Can't keep it within arm's reach. Now, here's Christofferson. Can she centre it this time? Bursting past McCormick, who does well. Does manage to make its way inside, but held on to by Keely Richards. Here's Whittle. Over the top this time for McKenzie. Cutting inside. McQueen intercepting. Going to go the other way to Bertolizio. One back well. Here's Whittle. Lifted in behind. Nice little dink. No foul given either. Here's Milivojevic having a crack from a long way out. Not quite hit the way she was after. Here's McCormick. Hecker, the wind picking up here at Perry Park. Corbett cutting inside now. The American getting the strike away. And always going wide. Here's Clark. Well dealt with by Holly McQueen. Turn from her as well, skipping through traffic. Does manage to find Sian Fryer. Here's Norrie. Switching the play. Now Della Harp. And the offside flag does go up on the Republic of Ireland international. Former Sydney FC and Perth Glory player, of course. Deborah Ann Della Harp. Their triumphs last year at Sydney FC. That's nice from the Roar. Della Harp trying to burst forward and Cannon Clough to her side's rescue. It's a lovely touch by Whittle. Just about 70 minutes gone here at Perry Park. Hecker out wide. Della Harp cutting inside now, the fullback getting the strike away this time. Can't beat Chloe Lincoln. It was a nice move from the Roar. Della Harp moving inside that time. The angle closed off by Sarah Clark. Far too hard to make anything of it. Here's Flannery. Bertolizio over the top this time. McCormick heading it down, only into the path of Milivojevic. Falling over that time was Norrie. Tish Woods able to handle it for the Brisbane Roar. Mish Norrie in game 100, of course. Been told she'll be awarded with some crystal after the game. Bit of glassware engraved with the club and game 100 as a thank you to her service to the league and to the club. A nice gesture from the Brisbane Roar. She'll be presented with it full time in front of the crowd. Here's Fryer. Corbin. Woods. It's a good ball forward from Tish Woods, but Tegan Bertolissia able to intercept it. Not under much pressure either. Well controlled by Whittle. McCormick, a risky ball. Not a bad one though, just to evade the pressure. Fryer in that battle on that far side with Flannery, and she wins out brilliantly. Sian Fryer, a lovely move. Putting Alex McKenzie down as well. This is brilliant down this left-hand side. The ball in now. Chloe Lincoln hangs on. A move like that deserved a goal at the end of it. A lovely bit of play from Sian Fryer and the Brisbane Roar. Here's Palmer. Cutting inside now. Brisbane Roar readying the substitutes once more. Beck Kirkham getting ready to come on. Deborah Della Harp perhaps making way. Here's Palmer. Finding Corbin. Options in the middle. This is good football from the Roar. Woods. Finding Hecker. Out wide now. Della Harp. Not bad. And Madeline Whittle. A bit of sand away. Not taking any chances. Is the youngster. Confirmation of that change on the far side. Deborah-Ann Della Harp making way. Rebecca Kirkham coming on, the former Lions FC player. And a personal trainer by day. Awarded with her first professional contract at the age of 30 this season. Which you simply love to see. Has been such a stalwart of that Lions FC side over the last few years. Up here in the MPLW Queensland. Here's Woods. Kirker. Woods does well. And it's sent out of play once more. A throw in again for the Brisbane Roar. About 16 minutes to play. Kirker, nice throw in now. Mario Hecker can't get onto the end of it. Will be a goal kick, Chloe Lincoln to take. Another change being made on that far side.
Substitution for Canberra United, number 19, Nicoletta Flannery replaced.
Canberra making the change, Nikki Flannery coming off. No foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin! Forward. Now for Stevenson. Across the face, Mia Corbin! Open goal! And just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box towards the byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline, Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline, Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. And what a save to years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back. Years. No foul though. And she moves the ball forward. Now for Stevenson, across the face, Mia Corbin! Forward, now for Stevenson, across the face, Mia Corbin! Open goal! And just got caught up in her feet. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now, looking to go across the face. Plenty of space allowed to her. Cannon Clough just setting off her. Corbin now looking to go across the face, and what a save. Finding the feet of Norrie in the box towards the byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. The byline. Ish Norrie, Mia Corbin. And what a save to Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back. Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post. Bundle. Years. Here's Della Harp now towards that back post. Bundled in by Jenna McCormick. Engaged today. Kisses the ring finger and opens the score. Years. Just over 14 minutes left in both sides' seasons. Can Canberra have one last hurrah? Can the Brisbane Roar end strong? Can they get their first win over Canberra? In nearly 1,500 days. Be a great result for them. And the perfect way to end the season. And end the season strong, as they have done, is Clark. A lifting ball into the box now. Falls down, cleared though by the Brisbane Roar. Here's Palmer. Down that left-hand side, one back by Canberra. Fryer under pressure from Milivojevic. Here's Norrie. Palmer. Back inside for Norrie now. Brisbane Roar working this left-hand side quite well so far in this game. Here's McQueen. Driving out of defence. The centre-back in that final third now, and the run by Beck Kirkup just held up. Confirmation of the attendance today. Over 2,800 people at Perry Park. A fantastic turnout on a beautiful Saturday afternoon here at Perry Park. And a great sign of where our league is at is Hecker. Clough trying to clear it. Canberra just struggling to clear their lines. Here's Woods. Feeding it in behind. That's a great ball for Fryer now. Saved by Lincoln and cleared by Cannon Clough. Here's Woods. Sasha Grove with a heavy challenge. Fryer. Palmer. Cutting inside now. Here's Fryer. Sasha Grove has done a great job at right back today.